students, ready for today?
So many new ideas, I'll work to make them worth. I can reach higher by trying hard. What will be my choice? My future I will write. I'm strong enough to fight for all my rights. To be a doctor, a janitor, a nurse, engineer, DJ, waiter, a policeman that serves. An actress, writer, driver, designer, you're free to choose the life that you deserve. Knowledge is the source in which I'll find my way. That's the start to make my dreams come true. I'll put my mind into getting in this world of work. To be myself a part of this world too. To be a doctor, a janitor, a nurse, engineer, DJ, waiter, a policeman that serves. An actress, writer, driver, designer, you're free to choose the life that you deserve.
Lesson 11, Knowing Your Family. Hi everyone! Hoje vamos direto a novos assuntos porque a aula passada foi uma revisão de tudo que vimos até agora, right?
Hello, Mariana.
Hi.
What are you doing?
I'm writing a letter to my brother.
Oh. Do you have brothers and sisters?
Yes, I do. I have one brother and one sister.
Oh, me too.
Mm-hmm.
How old is your sister? Is she pretty?
She's 33 years old and yes, she's pretty. But she has a husband, one son and two daughters.
Oh.
So you have one nephew and two nieces.
Yes, I do.
Novidade interessante. O verbo to do, que significa fazer. Foi assim que ele apareceu no primeiro diálogo. What are you doing? Ou seja, o que você está fazendo? Mas ele também pode ser um verbo auxiliar. Ele ajuda os outros verbos nas suas formas interrogativa ou negativa. O único verbo que não precisa de um auxiliar é o verbo to be. I have two brothers. Do I have two brothers? E para negar, I do not have two brothers. Ou I don't have two brothers.
Do you have brothers and sisters?
Yes, I do. I have one brother and one sister.
Oh, me too.
Hoje nosso encontro será sobre família, family. Para começar, brothers and sisters, irmãos e irmãs. Ah, e a expressão me too significa eu também.
How old is your sister? Is she pretty?
She's 33 years old and yes, she's pretty. But she has a husband, one son and two daughters.
Oh. So you have one nephew and two nieces?
Yes, I do.
Do you have any pictures?
Yes, I do. Those are my nieces. Their names are Anna and Sara. Anna is 7 years old and Sara is 3. And this is my nephew, Thiago. He's 5 years old.
Oh, look at them.
Outros membros da família. Husband, marido. Son, filho. Daughter, filha. Nephew, sobrinho. Niece, sobrinha. Perceberam que o verbo auxiliar do apareceu aí novamente?
Do you have any pictures?
Yes, I do.
No início, pode parecer um pouco estranha essa história de verbo auxiliar, mas aos poucos vocês se acostumam, ok? Don't worry, não se preocupem. Para he e she, o auxiliar to do assume uma outra forma, para he, she e it. Mas isso é assunto para o próximo encontro, ok?
This picture here is from my last birthday. This is my grandmother and my grandfather.
Are they from São Paulo too?
No, they aren't. They live in São Paulo, but they are from Acre.
Acre? Do you know Acre?
No, I don't. It's too expensive to go there.
How old are they? Do they work?
Yes, they do. They are 72 years old and they work every day, from 5 in the morning until 10 o'clock. They have a bakery.
Can you eat all you want?
Of course not, Pedro.
Oh.
Grandmother e grandfather. Well, mother, sabemos que é mãe. Father, pai. Grandmother é avó. Portanto, grandfather.
Hello, guys.
Hello.
What are you doing?
Mariana is showing me pictures of her family.
Really? Let me see.
Oh, here. This is my grandma and this is my grandpa. They work at a bakery in Sao Paulo.
Oh, great.
Aren't they cute?
Yeah.
I love them.
I have pictures of my family too. Do you want to see them?
Yes, we do.
O verbo want já apareceu aqui pra gente outras vezes. Ele significa querer e também precisa de um auxiliar para se transformar em uma pergunta. Por isso, a Júlia disse: Do you want to see it?
Man, do you have a big family?
Yes, I do. My grandma has 9 daughters, 7 sons and 25 grandsons.
So you have 24 cousins?
Yeah.
I don't have a family that big.
Me neither. Great.
24 cousins! 24 primos! Big, big family! Outra novidade é a expressão me neither, que é igual ao me too, mas utilizamos para concordar com uma negação. É igual ao nosso eu também não. Vejam de novo como ela apareceu.
I don't have a family that big.
Me neither.
Sim, a Júlia também não tem uma família tão grande.
Do you know all of them?
Yes, I do. And we are all friends. See? Those are all my cousins.
Oh, great.
Hey, that is my ex-girlfriend.
Who? Carla?
Yes.
She's my cousin and a really good friend.
Well, she can be a good friend, but she's not a good girlfriend, that is for sure. Oh, wow. That is a really pretty woman. Who is she? Can I have her phone number?
That's my mother, in 1975.
Well, do you have any single cousins or nieces or sisters of my age?
Yes, I do. Here. This is Bruna. That is Leila, and this one here is Sheila.
Wow, they're all very pretty.
Está na hora da nossa revisão. Well, aprendemos um verbo auxiliar que é o verbo to do. Ele auxilia outros verbos, com exceção do verbo to be, a se transformarem em frases interrogativas ou negativas. Vamos a um exemplo. They have a big family. Do they have a big family? They don't have a big family. E por falar em família, speaking of family, aprendemos os nomes dos nossos parentes. Let's take a look. Grandmother, grandfather, father, dad, mother, mom, daughter, son, brother, sister, niece, nephew, uncle, aunt, cousins. E a dica de hoje? Pesquise a sua árvore genealógica para saber de onde vem a sua família, enfim, a sua história. Ok, teacher, good luck, they're all yours. Kisses, bye-bye.
So many new ideas, I'll work to make them worth. I can reach higher by trying hard. What will be my choice? My future I will write. I'm strong enough to fight for all my rights. To be a doctor, a janitor, a nurse, engineer, DJ, waiter, a policeman that serves, an actress, writer, driver, designer, you're free to choose the life that you deserve. Knowledge is the source in which I'll find my way. That's the start to make my dreams come true.